Hello everyone. In today's video lecture of SolidWorks part drawing, we'll focus on one more exercise here on the screen with all the dimensions given. Now again, we can start with the top view here also, the way we have did for our previous exercises. We can draw a rectangle followed by, you can remove two steps of materials. Okay, that can be done. Again, to do this, we need to consider the outer boundary. Outer boundary is a rectangle of 60 by 40, which is the top view. So we'll select top, a sketcher, consider a rectangle, place a rectangle and define it with dimension 60 by 40. 60 by 40. Fine, and fit it to the screen so that you'll have a better visual effect. This is how we have developed outer boundary. Then extrude the sketcher completely from top to bottom or bottom to top, which is of 40 mm height. Okay, fit it to the screen again. Done. Now from this particular existing component, we need to remove material. Okay, that material removal can be done. I'll just select top face sketcher, keep the component normal to the window, fine, and take a line as the option. Start drawing the shape, whatever the shape existing there, irrespective of dimensions, draw that particular shape which you could see in the sketcher. This is the shape which I have drawn, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 40. This is maintaining 40 mm out of 60. If this is maintaining 40, the other two sides going to be 10 and 10 mm. Similarly, how about this? These two are 20. This will maintain some dimension. That we will check it out. Here it has given 20. Okay, so 40 by 20 dimensions we need to set. So go to smart dimension. This is supposed to be 20 mm, and this is supposed to be 40. Till here it is okay. But we have to set the corner distances. From this corner to this corner, it is going to be 10. Fine, this is set now. Similarly, from here to this point again, from this corner to extreme end point, it is going to be 20 again. Now it is fit completely, properly. Exit. Now here in this case, it got removed material up to 30 mm. Just have a look, because their base, there is a material of 10 mm. I'll use an option called extrude cut and remove material up to 30. Sorry, I just make it 30 and okay. Have a look at the component. This is how we can develop the component. Fine. Now we need to give chamfer session from one end to the other. Fine. That can be done by this way. Now this is how you could see. I'll go to an option called chamfer, okay, on this edge and this edge. Have a look on both the edges, which is 10 by 45. I'll try to increase the value here. Check it out. But when I try to give the value is 30 by 45 degrees. When it is 30 by 45 degrees, this particular point, this point is not reaching the extreme corner. So in chamfer, this is not the option that we need to choose. We need to choose the second option, which is distance. Okay, when you take distance as option, symmetric, from this symmetric you make it as axis symmetric and give your values. Now change this to 40 and 30. Okay, just say okay. Have a look at the component. Okay, what we did now, I'll just repeat this. I'll go to feature addition, and what we did is we have changed it from distance angle to distance. Both are distances, so that you can play with both the numbers to reach your destiny or create a component. And I'll just keep the component in isometric view. Set it. That is the same thing you could see here. Okay, now the same option can be done by using what you call extrude cut also, by drawing a right angle triangle on this face or the back face. okay, but this is the right way to do. You can use chamfers when and where required, which is very much important again how to use them. This is how we'll develop a component. Okay, any queries you can comment in the box provided. Thank you for now.